Oh, man.
Hey, what's up, guys? Kenshi here. Welcome back to my channel. So today we decided to take the pinstriping off Tia. And to those new to my channel, Tia is my 97 Mazda Miata M edition. And so mine actually came from the dealership. So I found out through research that the Miata came from the factory with nothing at all. So it was a dealer install to either go with the pinstriping or go with this it's the color matching door molding that goes like halfway across the door. So I don't really like the gold pinstriping. I think it kind of ages the car. And so I decided to take it off. And the tool we'll use is, thank you, Elliot. So this is called a rubber eraser wheel. And I picked it up from eBay, of course. And this is not sponsored, unfortunately. So what comes with it in the box is the rubber wheel. And it comes with the adapter that you would screw on and then you would attach it to your drill. And it's pretty much made out of rubber. It smells very nostalgic. Like I just think of like middle school or something. So yeah, it's pretty much literally a giant rubber eraser wheel. And on the back, it'll tell you how much you can use of it. You know, after a while, it'll start wearing down. So once it reaches that line here, then you have to stop using it. And also, it says max 4,000 RPM, and I have no clue what 4,000 RPM will be. So we'll just go as fast as we need to take off the pinstriping, and then we'll go from there. So it should be a quick and easy process. So gonna head down to the garage, so meet you there. What's up, guys? So welcome to the garage. So as mentioned before, in order to use the eraser wheel, it comes with an adapter for your drill, and all you do is just you screw it on, right? Pretty easy. And then you get a drill, whatever drill you have, and remember that it says max 4,000 RPM. I have no clue what it is. I just feel that you just do it as enough speed to be comfortable. Make sure your clutch is on the, if you do have one, the clutch, it's on the lowest setting so that it'll just stop, you know. And then you do want to go forward. And then when you're getting down to it, you want to make sure you're close enough and comfortable enough. Try and make sure that you're not going to hit the wall. I mean, hit the car body with the drill. So I'm having my arm here. Can you see it, Elliot? Right?
Mm-hmm.
So
don't put it there. That will...
Yeah, don't put it where it spins, obviously. And then you just start. You're going to be going a back and forth motion. And the first thing it's going to make you do is going to go like, either go up. It's going to make you go up naturally. So it'd be easier when you're going to lay it on there first. And then you start using it. Really hard to control. And slowly but surely, it's not the best thing, but you don't want to leave it too long in one spot, you know. And so it's not the best thing, but you know, you see it's starting to come off. It's definitely easier than just you peeling it off.
That's what we did before.
Yeah, it would take so long. And
we barely get anything off.
Yeah. There we go. Oh, okay, so what it is just make sure it's flat. It's resting flat. Man, it even smells like that rubber. I might have to adjust the clutch a little higher. And then you get the idea, you just keep doing this. And it'll start to come off. And then, you know, once you, so after you take it off, it's going to leave the residue. You could either use lacquer thinner, I mean, or I just use alcohol, you know, just grab a rag or don't use a terry cloth. And then it'll just, the residue will come right off. And after this, I'm going to detail it. I'm going to clay bar it. So, and it's not bad for, you know, some, the pinstripe's been on there for like 23 years, I guess, right? I did the math right, and you can barely tell, right? You can't really. So I was afraid of that. They'll leave a little mark. If you look really close, you will see residue, but I think the clay bar will get that off. So we're going to do one side for you, and we'll be right back. Hey guys, you definitely have to be very patient, and if it's arm day, then you could skip that day in the gym. This is really gonna work your guns. I took some spinach offline, so I'm good. But yeah, so it took us about how long to do this? About 10 minutes, Elliot?
Yeah.
So we got, you know, this much off in 10 minutes, and it's not, you know, it's definitely just take your time. I feel like an angle sometimes is better, but and then you switch to a flat. So you start in the angle and then go flat and then just keep going back and forth. And it works pretty good. Just wish it was a faster process. But so yeah, you just keep doing it all the way around. And then so yeah, we'll be back. So we're almost done with one side. And I'm getting used to it now, so it is quicker. I'm not sure if I'm going too fast, but it's about a medium speed and not too much pressure. I noticed if you put too much pressure, it's harder to take off. So just about a medium pressure. Okay, we'll be right back. Okay guys, so we couldn't get through the whole pinstriping just because the battery died on my drill. So, but you guys get the idea. Just go slow, and pretty much later on I will clay bar and all that, so you'll leave the residue, but didn't take that long to do one side at least. Unfortunately, the battery died. I know most of you probably has those drills with the second battery that came with it, but mine doesn't have it, so. So yeah, so after this, I'll probably do a clay bar. I might do that on a video, actually, just to show you guys what I do to detail the car. So, okay guys, that's it. Hope you enjoyed the video. And what do they need to do, Elliot?
Press the like button and subscribe.
That's right, guys. Love you guys. Take care.